haven't already seen from the title, today is a DIY video, and it's basically making your very own leather. It's a signature graphic bands, like, and they're so easy to make as well. You can make as many as you like, and I'll just be showing you how. So if you are interested in these, then keep watching. Okay guys, so you're going to start by taking 4 strips of pleather, and these strips of pleather should measure about 5 or 6 centimetres more than the circumference of your wrist. So my wrist measures 16 centimetres, and so my strips will measure 22 centimetres. But remember that everyone is different, so remember to measure your wrist first beforehand before cutting any strips, and add an extra 5 or 6 centimetres on top. Okay, so we're just here, I'm just basically gluing the strips together from 4 strips to make 2. Remember, if you're using pleather like me, to glue the underside of the material and not the shiny side, because you want the shiny side to show on top. Don't use a lot of glue, but a little bit, and remember to press down quite firmly so that it actually sticks, otherwise your fabric will start to come apart when we start to decorate it. And yeah, that's it. Okay, and now you're going to take a pair of scissors and trim the ends if need be, to smarten up a little bit, make it a little straighter if you want to. And that's the first bit of the tutorial done. Okay, so now you're going to cut 4 extra strips, and these are going to measure about, I'd say, 4 centimeters long, and these are going to be stuck on the ends of the 2 strips that we've created, and this is going to just join the strips together to make the cuff. So again, just pop a bit of glue on the end of each of the smaller strips and stick to the longer strips to join them together, and double up again so that it's stronger. And seeing as the pleather isn't such a sturdy material, you need to make it quite strong so that it will stay in place. Yeah, do this on the other side, and as well turn it over and stick the other 2 strips on the back. And again, if you need to, remember to cut off any excess pieces of fabric from the ends so that it looks smart, and you want it to look as rectangular as you can. Okay, so now we have a rectangular cuff that is ready to decorate. Okay, so on to the next section. So here I'm going to decorate my cuff, and I'm just going to use a abstract geometric design. So basically just sort of using strips to create triangles within the center of the cuff. You can do whatever you like, but this is what I'm going to do. So if you want to do this one, here I am doing it pretty quickly. So yeah, there, I've done that. And again, if there's any extra material, you know what to do, cut it off. Okay, so that's our first cuff done and dusted, and you can leave it like that if you want to, or you could do something else, but I'll show you how to design another one later on. But yeah, we're just going to sort out the fastening. So to actually get this cuff to stay in place, the first fastening I'm going to show you is a simple tie knot. So you're just going to thread another piece of pleather through the loops in your cuff and tie a secure knot, and that will keep it in place. And here I am showing you. And that's really nice, it's quite dainty, and that fastening, and it's really good to sort of tighten and loosen whenever you please. Okay, so guys, we're on to the second cuff now, and I've just quickly done the first steps before this bit because you don't need to see it again. So for this one, I'm going to be decorating it. Yay! So now we're going to take our paint. I actually recommend you should probably use fabric paint because I'm sure it will stay longer. But if you don't have it, then you can always use your nail paint. I'm not sure of the staying power of the nail paint, but if you have a top coat at hand, then you can use your top coat and spread a little bit on so that it doesn't rub away or anything. So yeah, you're going to take your paint, whether it be nail paint or fabric paint, and dab a little bit of that paint on the tip of your sponge. You can use whatever tool you like. I've just decided the sponge is better than the paintbrush. So put as much colour on that sponge as possible, and you're just going to apply it by either dabbing, painting, whatever method that you'd like to do, as long as you cover the entire strip of pleather. Just keep building up that colour by dabbing more and more paint on until you're happy with the finish. Okay, so guys, make sure that you wait until your fabric is completely dry. So mine is nice and silvery and crispy now that it's dry, and just looks like a really pretty dainty metallic band. You can do whatever you want. Again, you can choose whatever colours, but I've decided I want to go with silver today. Okay, so you can take your other colours, whatever you decide to do. I'm actually doing a spotty or polka dot design on mine, so I'm going to apply a bit of gold nail paint onto my Q-tip here, and I'm just going to press some spots onto the pleather. So now it looks like that, and it looks really nice because it's dried. Okay, I've skipped a step off camera. I've actually attached the smaller pieces of pleather to the sides to create the cuff because it just takes too long, and you've already seen it. You don't need to see it again. So now we have our cuff, and it is ready to fasten onto our wrist. So for this particular fastening, this is going to be a different one I'm going to show you. You're going to take an extra piece of pleather, and this extra piece of pleather is going to act as the sort of binder of the cuff. So you're going to pick up your cuff and put it on your wrist and determine where you want the cuff to be tied. If you want it loose, then you tie it looser. If you want it to be quite tight, then you tie it tighter, obviously. So yeah, when you have decided what you want, you're just going to take your piece of pleather and cut it into four smaller parts. Again, these smaller parts are going to be stuck together to make two smaller parts, and these parts are going to go across the ends of the cuff to create a sort of joint to bind it together. Okay, so now this is what it looks like. This is what you should have if you stick it in place. So you have two strips of fabric stuck together that joins the rest of the cuff together, and you should use two because it is stronger than using one, and I'm sure if you're going to be putting it over your wrist, you're going to be doing a lot of stretching. So now you should be able to slip it securely onto your wrist without it falling off, and here I will show you how easy it is now and just how pretty it looks. I just love this particular bracelet. It's so nice, so dainty, and probably goes with everything. So yeah guys, that's it. That's the tutorial. That's the second one done as well, and yeah, those are my pleather cuff bracelet things. Here's another one that I did, which is really pretty. I love this one actually. It's sort of a floral design, and it's sort of blue and pink, and yeah, that's a really good one for spring actually. So if you like that one, you can also do that one too. But yeah, you can do whatever you want. As I said, it shows your personality, and anything that you'd like, put it on there. Okay, so guys, I want to thank you for watching this video. I really hope that you have enjoyed, because I really enjoyed making these bracelets. So versatile, and yeah, you can do whatever you want. Again, as I probably said 100 times, just make it what you want it to be. So yeah, thank you so much for tuning in, and I will see you guys in my next video. Oh wait, here's some more that I made before. This was supposed to say bang. I'm sorry, that is upside down. Yeah, that was supposed to be, say bang. And this is the one that I made of you guys. Yeah. Okay, so now I probably will go. So thank you guys for watching. And thumbs up if you like this video as well.